Recently, I've got a comment that agrees with my thoughts na there's a lack of creators in the self-development, self-improvement, self-growth niche dito sa Philippines. And if you want to do YouTube in a business sense, definitely do tech, beauty, or travel. Anyways, what I want to share in today's video is a breakdown or review of my favorite local podcast, which is Wake Up with Jim and Saab. And the reason behind is because I got a lot of value in listening to their podcast, and if you appreciate my type of content, which is personal finance / self-development, you definitely have to listen to their podcast. But before I do a deep dive about their content, let me share other local content creators muna that I think is in the same niche. First, I want to introduce Ayin Bernos. So I first saw her sa channel ng Record 8.
Hi, I'm Ayin Bernos. I am a vlogger, small business owner. I'm the founder of Morena the Label.
So she is the owner of Morena the Label. She has a blog called Sunkissed Somewhere. She does public speaking. And also, she has a YouTube channel under her name. And what I like about her content is, for me, it signifies women empowerment. And it's rare dito sa Philippines because most women creators dito are eye candy lang, pabebe lang, or pa-cute lang. So, nothing wrong with that, to be honest. Ang sa akin lang, let's have some diversity, and if you appreciate women empowerment, you should definitely check her channel out. Another channel that I would love to recommend is yung kay Nate Ponzalan.
How to figure out what to do after you get.
There's some adulting videos there in his channel, so you definitely have to check it out. Lastly, yung kay Bianca Intal, meron siyang series dito sa YouTube na paano ba to? It seems informative to me, but to be honest, I never watched one pa.
Tell us about your journey from being one of the original digital natives.
If you know other creators in the same kind of niche, kindly comment them below. I'd love to check their content out. Back to the main point of this video, I dig some old videos of Jim and Saab, sila yung host of their podcast, and nakita ko yung pinakaunang iteration of their content, which is back in 2016. So literal, kakagising lang nila.
I'm gonna start our podcast. I have your coffee here. It's recording. Am I doing this right? I'm recording it here.
Yeah.
Welcome to Wake Up with Saab and Jim. Concept for this show is just basically waking up with us.
And probably doon nila talaga kinuha yung title of their show. And back then, there's no Pancho and Vito pa. All they have is yung dog nila.
Di pa ba kayo nagpabalak ni Jim na magka-baby?
Ito yung baby namin, oh. What are you talking about? Always had a baby.
Much, much, much later.
And it's cool na to look back kasi I just got into consuming their content back in 2018. So parang to look where they are now, 2019, and to look back in 2016, it was really fun and cool para sa akin, which is, I'm a fan of them. Hindi ko na maalala yung unang napakinggan ko or napanood na episode nila, but majority of their content is about life, especially about love life and career. Siguro, quick background story na lang muna about them. So si Jim, based from what I've heard sa podcast nila, was a former corporate employee and usually runs about working for big corporations in the Philippines. And back then daw, if sa batch nila, if you're not working for a big corporation or a fortune corporation, you're a loser. And usually runs about yung how to climb yung corporate ladder dito sa Pinas. Dami daw hanash na kailangan mo pang to go out and socialize with your boss outside work. And kay Saab naman, what I learned from listening to them is she's an OG blogger. Obviously, she's a mom to Pancho and Vito. And she comes from a showbiz family, but she really talks about it in the pod. And both of them are part of their band called Cheats. What I like about their podcast is their authenticity, especially with Saab. Parang siya yung tropa mo na walang tinatago sa'yo and just genuine love.
Nainom, sabihin mo na nainom.
Oh, tanya, ano to, join forces tayo, awayin natin to. Kasi binrikan niya yung friend natin.
Parang libre yung beer dito, yung beer ng tatay ko nandiyan, oh, pwede natin inumin yan. Bakit tayo lalabas, magbibihis, tas gagastos ng 150 para sa club?
Parang babae sa bahay ng tatay mo.
Plus, they say bad words during their podcast.
Putang ina, ba tayo magka-club?
But Jim naman, what I like about him is he's a critical thinker. And if you listen to him, he's definitely going to add value sa life mo.
Go out and make friends.
Yeah, go out and make friends. And also, why I say you have to go to events and workshops is because Well, personally, I think the best way to be parang, to be attractive is to work on yourself internally. And if you love what you're doing, it's gonna radiate. I mean, you're gonna radiate.
Yeah.
And it's gonna be attractive. If you see someone who's so passionate about what they're doing, isn't that so attractive?
The best, parang the most successful hookup. Is that a proper term? The most successful
hookup.
Connection is one that is based on friendship.
Mm-hmm.
Diba?
Mm-hmm.
Yun lang. Wow, may lesson.
Oh, nga'y.
There's a lesson.
Kasi ngayon, how I see things is everyone's banking on sensationalism. When you look at Xander Ford and Zian Gasa, alam mo yun, they're willing to trade yung dignity nila over influence. Even yung KMJS ngayon, I used to watch their show, but ngayon parang they're just for the views kasi nga sensationalize na lang nila yung show nila. What I just wanted to emphasize is when you look at yung style ng Wake Up the Gym and Saab, pwede ka namang hindi maging sensationalized. Parang you can get influenced by not sensationalizing yourself. So yun lang, parang if you really add value to your audience, kahit hindi pang sensationalize yung show mo, it will definitely work. Another thing that I appreciate ko from their podcast is they really try to improve their show through cleaning yung audio nila, through engaging with their audience, through yung malibag nila, which is yung mailbag of questions from their audience, to now bringing guests to their show. So, alam mo yun, para sa akin, one of my bucket list is to be guested sa show nila. So, hopefully, one day. Let me wrap this video up na lang. They're the number one podcast dito sa Philippines. And if you like listening to podcasts that add value sa inyo, definitely go listen to them. They talk about topics ranging from self-development, productivity, up to entertainment. Last na lang, I also have a podcast. It's called Jeg's Podcast. I only have 5 episodes yet. But I'll be uploading one before the year end. So, ayun lang. If you like this video, hit the like button. Subscribe for more videos na kagaya nito. Or if you are into self-development or personal finance, subscribe to my channel. You know the drill. Alright, that's it. Bye!